know that you can. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me in the morning, I'll be on the way. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me out by your...
Ding dong.
Hey guys, how's it going?
Hello, how are you?
Are we like the gray squad today?
Yeah,
I think we are.
Completely unplanned, of course. And I had just thrown something on too, like 10 minutes before this. I was like, this looks comfy. We're good. I'm glad we're matching now.
Me too. Didn't even plan it.
No. So on Thursdays we wear gray.
Yes.
I love it. I'm so happy to be here with you guys.
Yes, same. Yes. So we wanted to talk about first time home buying today.
Yes.
Home buyers, home buying, you know, all things related to that. Cooper, did you have anything in mind to start us off?
Yeah, so you know, I do work with a lot of first time home buyers, like most of us do in real estate, because there is just like a huge amount of first time home buyers, of course. And, you know, it just came down to the point where, you know, he really didn't want to get pre-qualified because the fact is he didn't want to hand over his bank account. And, you know, at that point, like me, you know, there's points where I have to, you know, walk them, he, she, whatever it may be, them through the process. Of, you know, this is a good thing. You know, we want the lenders to look at your bank accounts. We want them to look at how much money you have, because the more money you have saved up somewhere, whether it be like savings, 401k, stocks, whatever it may be, the lender will be able to see it. And then you could just get more for your pre-qualification. So that was just something that I had to have a conversation with my first time home buyer. And then after that, he was like, all right, send in all my information for the pre-qual.
Were you going to say something, Thomas?
I mean, yeah, totally. I mean, yeah, you were talking about how he didn't want to, you know, share his bank account information, all that. I mean, the lender also, just like us as realtors, we're under a confidentiality fiduciary duties. So anything that they share with the lender isn't necessarily shared with us. Like, that's all confidential with the lender. We don't see your bank accounts. We don't see your stocks and bonds. You
Perfect.
As a client. Yeah, we don't see any of that. I mean, if the client wants to share it with us, that's their decision, and they can, and we will keep that confidential too. But I mean, we don't, anything that you send to the lender, all, you know, your W-2s, 1099s, we don't see any of that. So
even then, I'm like, don't send it to me. I'm not a lender. I don't deal with money.
Exactly.
Talk to the lender. I'm like, don't even get me started.
I just want your pre-approval letter, the one-page document. We're good.
Yeah, that's it. And then just listen to the lender, because, you know, there's at times to where I do have to go back and talk to the lender and figure out what is needed for our client. And that's why, you know, all of us work so well together in a team when it comes to like having a good lender to work for our first time home buyers. And that's what they need most of the time is, you know, the guidance, because they have no clue. I had no clue. When I bought my first home, I was like, what's happening? I had no idea what was going on. I was just told to sign on the line, be happy that you were able to get a house, you know, like I was like, okay, dad, like, and I bought my own house. So it's like, it was just a huge experience to know, like, I had no clue. And that's why also I wanted to get into real estate, is to help a lot of first time home buyers. You know, that just led into just like helping so many. But yeah, it was just like the whole point of like me not knowing what I, you know, didn't know. And I wanted to teach my first time home buyers everything that I didn't. So yeah, it's great. I love working with them.
Absolutely. And, you know, to your point, you don't know what you don't know. So that's why we rely on the professionals, you know, so talk to a lender and get an understanding of everything in your financial world and where you stand. You know, some people check their credit score on like Credit Karma, which that's good if you're keeping an eye on it, you know, like it, at least you are somewhat doing something, but you need to get a more accurate picture. And unfortunately, that's not going to be with Credit Karma. So, you know, talk to a lender, they will run your credit. And they will look at your debt to income. They will look at any past, you know, foreclosures, bankruptcies, you know, at all of that. There's so many working pieces And that's why we, you know, we need the lenders so they can evaluate all of that information and determine, you know, if you can get pre-approved or not. So super, super important. Totally.
And I mean, I just noticed some people can't comment on some stuff. So I just went to my Facebook real quick to clear out a public post for everyone to be able to post some comments, because it says underneath a lot of people can't make comments. So I haven't seen any comments. So if you're trying to comment, we would love to see a comment. If you have questions, reach out to us. We'd love to get some questions. And, you know, and that's why we set it up on the StreamYard, is to make this accessible to everyone to be able to ask questions when we are speaking. So, you know, and we just started. So if there's technical difficulties, like, we'll get through it. Oh, dang. You know, just say that we have technical difficulties just to have someone say hi. Hey, Megan. Oh, awesome. Thank you so much for being here. Perfect. Good.
I'm going to go check mine really quick, because it says if you go and check your privacy. Yes.
Yep. So I just went and changed mine, because, you know, then again, like all of us, even in real estate, we don't want to be public with everything. So
I'm on my phone today, so it may be having some issues. Normally I'm on my laptop, but who knows? Laptop will be back next week.
You got a fan, Lindsay. Oh, hello, Pamela. Welcome.
But yeah, I mean, also with first time home buyers right now, rent is going up. So, you know, they're all renting. Rent is absolutely insane. I think it's projected to go up another 7 to 9% this year. And I mean, you're already paying, you know, $1,500 plus for a one bedroom in downtown Columbus. Like, put that towards a mortgage. Like, that's just absolutely crazy. And now your rental payment history can be used as part of your pre-approval with your lender. That just came out a couple months ago. So that's super awesome too. That's definitely a perk for first time home buyers. It's now, you know, your rental payment history plays a part in your pre-approval process. So
yeah, that is nice. You know, and there's programs out there to help first time home buyers. Whether you're in Ohio or Michigan, and if you need help with down payment assistance, you can reach out to Lindsay and Thomas. You know, if you're in the Northeast Ohio area, reach out to Lindsay. If you're in the Columbus area, definitely Thomas. But for me, for Michigan, because there are definitely programs and loans out there to help you figure out what's best for you and for you to be able to save money and, you know, achieve the goal of buying your first home ever, because it's such a great equity opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. 100%. Thomas, I thought you had something else you were going to say, but then Cooper went. I don't know. Did you have anything?
No, I mean, Cooper, not that I remember at least, but Cooper just made me think of, like, there's also like a grants for grad program too that you can apply for. So if you are a graduate, there's first time home buyer programs for that. There's like military ones. If you know, or a National Guard or ROTC in college, if you served in any of the armed forces, there's definitely first time home buyer programs for those people as well. Teachers, first responders, all of those. You know, we can pair you up with a lender to go more in detail. I'm not a licensed mortgage advisor, so I don't know all the details about them. They're definitely always changing. Hey, Tyler, how are you? So yeah, it's definitely something to mention too, is there's lots of different programs. It's not just, you know, one mortgage does not fit every buyer.
Right.
It's definitely important to make sure you know what's aware out there and talk with a lender that is able to match you up with those products as well.
Yep, absolutely. And that's, you know, what I'm sure a lot of people are unaware of, you know, like there are so many different loan products, so many. So definitely, I mean, and I'm not just saying this because we all are, but I think honest to God, like when you're looking for a house, the first step is hire a realtor. Mm-hmm. Find a realtor first. They have contacts for lenders. They have contacts for everything you need, you know? So really, truly, I mean, you could go to your bank and get a pre-approval. But let me tell you, a realtor probably is going to have at least three better lenders for you to look into. So, you know, that's you know, why we're here. So
yes. I would
really yes. encourage anybody who's watching this right now, if you have never purchased a home before, you're thinking about it, reach out to one of the three of us, seriously, and just pick our brains. That's what we're here for. You know, that I always just try and drive that point home to people. You know, it's like, that's my job. I'm like, mm-hmm. no, there's no too many questions. There's no dumb question. Like, if you've never done this before, you've never done it before, you know? So,
so a lot of this, it's so funny that you bring up also like the rental market, because I've been seeing a lot of, what is it? The reactions to rental prices going up mm-hmm. all over social media. And it's just people opening up their emails and having to notice this skyrocket increase, especially when it comes to like inner cities. So, you know, I'm not a part of like an inner city, you know, I'm 40 minutes north out of, you know, north out of Detroit. So nowhere near inner city. You know, do you see like a huge increase like within inner city, like such as Columbus, or do you see it just like everywhere right now with you guys in Ohio?
I think it's everywhere, honestly. Mm-hmm. I mean, even in, you know, cause I'm further south than Cleveland. But like even in Cleveland, there it's everywhere. Everybody's getting more rent right now.
I completely agree. And I mean, in Columbus too, they're building all these new communities, like apartment complexes and all that. I mean, yeah. I have friends down there that rent, and I mean, rent is crazy what they're getting for rent, and it's always fully occupied. I mean, they're not hurting for renters. So if they can find someone that will pay it, they'll charge it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Pamela, great statement. I'm just going to pull it up.
Mm-hmm.
Totally makes sense because, you know, as me, you know, I get it. You know, rent's going up. Right now, fortunately, I don't have to raise my rent because I have a rental property. But who knows? I'm, you know, having to pay homestead taxes. So, you know, we will see if anything changes dramatically. And especially in the area that I'm currently in the state of Michigan, you know, I have looked at the homestead taxes when it's changing for like the rentals. But, you know, we're done talking about rentals. We're trying to get people into homes. So we're trying to help first time home buyers. So yeah, you know, perfect example. If you're sick of these rents, you know, having to go up, you know, really mm-hmm. see what, you know, your job is going to be able to get you capable of, you know, see what the money is you have available to be able to put down for a down payment. You know, we definitely want to get you into a house for sure. So thank you so much, Pamela.
Totally. And I mean, it's completely free to talk to us, to talk to a lender. I mean, there's no cost.
Nope.
And yeah, just like if you have any questions, like reach out, please. It's completely free. We're happy to answer any questions you may have.
Yes, I completely agree. Do you have anything like that? Do you guys like have any stories recently that you've had to deal with? Like I have a bunch of first time home buyers reaching out to me right now.
Oh my gosh. I mean, mm-hmm. I feel like everyone that I have helped as of lately, there's at least, you know, like every other transaction is at least a first time home buyer. I mean, everyone thinks, so like there's this stereotype, right? That like, oh my God, it's such a horrible time to buy, you know, but we as realtors know, no, that's actually not the truth. You know, the interest mm-hmm. rates are what you need to take advantage of, because mm-hmm. when your purchase price maybe potentially comes down in the future, which they're really not even projecting at all this year, you know, their values are going to sustain this year. But so when your purchase price does come down and your interest rate goes up, you're going to have more in a mortgage payment than you would with a lower interest rate mm-hmm. and higher purchase price. So it's, mm-mm. you know, it's a myth we got to help bust, you know.
Totally. And they say that for every point that interest rates go up, so, you know, now we're in the threes. Yeah. Every point that they go up, so, you know, 4%, 5%, 6%, you lose 10% of your purchasing power. So, you know, if you were going to get a $300,000 mortgage at 3%, when interest rates go up to 4%, you're only be able to afford $270,000. So yep. It definitely affects your purchasing too, and how much house you can afford.
Yep.
Yes, correct. And, you know, going off of that too, like first time home buyers drive the seller's market. You know, people are so worried about like not selling their home or not being able to get into a second home or anything like that. And they're trying to sell quick. The best people to get a hold of, you know, whether they're FHA or conventional, it doesn't matter. If they're first time home buyers, you know, someone wants to be in that house. Mm-hmm. You know, someone wants to start, you know, laying down roots. So, you know, first time home buyers, I think, are always perfect for someone that's always trying to upgrade or downsize or whatever it may be.
I agree.
Yeah.
Completely agree.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Did you guys have anything else you wanted to touch on?
No.
I think so.
We just love first time home buyers.
I love them. I mean, I definitely specialize with first time home buyers, especially because of my age, for sure. A lot of my peers and people I graduated with, classmates, are all, you know, buying their first homes for the first time. It's always so exciting just to see, you know, their faces and when they're in their first home ever. I remember when I bought my first home, like how exciting that is. Like it really is. I mean, it's one of your like most major life events, buying your first house. And that's so cool. So
I know.
It is. It's so exciting. So exciting.
So fun, tiny fact just off that. My insurance company, I'm changing everything because of my rental, blah, blah, blah. But she was like, hey, do you remember when you bought your house? I'm like, yeah, of course. It was my first house. I'm like, blah, 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 blah. She was like, that's very specific. I'm like, well, yeah, bought my first house. Of course, I'm going to remember the date. Mm-hmm. Like, come on now. So yeah, it's, you know, it's one of those like greatest accomplishments, you know, a success of feeling, you know, establishment of adulthood, you know, and it definitely was. And I learned a lot too. So I love it. I definitely, want people to buy with us, whether you're in Ohio or Michigan.
Absolutely. Right. Absolutely. Awesome, guys. Well, thanks for joining us today. And as always, if you guys have any questions, you know, shoot us in the comments or send us a DM. We would love to talk to you guys.
Totally.
Yes.
Right. Peace out.
Bye.
Bye, you guys.
In your garden, you know that you can. Call me when you want.